Okay, the next tab is email under settings. Okay, and we're going to, I would say, wait on this until you can figure out more about it. This will enable you to email to your blog and send whatever you want to your blog, but then if someone else finds out about your email address, they can too post to your blog. So I don't set that right away. Blog authors, I also leave that the way it is, and I'm just the only author. And blog readers, anybody can read your blog here. Then we get to layout. Okay, layout, this is a bunch of stuff on this one. Okay, there's kind of get used to and comfortable to this, you know, with this page, to just sort of look at it for a few minutes so that when we start navigating, no worries. The first part we're going to cover is where it says blog posts right in the middle of the page. Right down at the bottom of that, there's a little edit thing right in the under the blog posts, and we're going to click on that, and this is what you'll see. And then you can change the settings on all of those things, kind of go over that and look at it. And then the next thing we're going to do is click on add a page element, okay? And this is what you're going to see. You have all these choices. You have slideshow, pictures, you can add a poll, you can do HTML, text. It's sort of like little widgets, okay? And you just pick one, and then you add it to your blog, all right? Now, the first one we're going to pick is the blog archive, okay? When your blog starts getting pretty full, this archive is pretty helpful for your visitors because then it'll show them all the posts and everything. I usually keep that towards the top. But I change the title for sure. And they don't call it the blog archive. Anyways, then we'll move on to editing the About Me. And you can change the title of that, too, to whatever you want. You just go through and edit, and be sure to save the changes as you go. And then I always add a newsreel. I like them. You can change the search term to whatever you want. And the newsreel will just search all the news articles and pick some relevant articles on your topic. And you change the title. And be sure, again, to click Save Changes before you exit out of there, okay? The next thing is videos, adding videos. You can pick any keywords here, change the title. You can actually even pick a channel on YouTube to put on there of your own or someone else's, any of that. And then you click Save Changes. And then I always add a poll or two or three or seven because they're fun. People like to take quizzes and polls. So, and you can add as many answers as you want and let people choose multiple answers, that sort of thing. And then you click Save. And then, now we're going to move on to the layout, okay? The layout is a little lengthy for the fonts and colors, so I'm not really going to go over that too much, but I'm going to give you a little pointers on these colors. Okay, so it's kind of self-explanatory here, but this is going to change the way your layout looks. You can change the header, the title, font, and color. You can change on this first on the left-hand side under One Star Health, the first little check mark I have here. Those are the things that you can change. And you just click on the color, and the color will change in the box. You click the box, you change the color. Okay? That's pretty simple, too. And then the next thing is edit HTML. I would say don't fool with that unless you're ready. So just skip to that and then pick your template. Now you can change your template here and then go back to fonts and colors and adjust it if you want. So you can change it up, and I would say definitely start changing up and be happy with it before you post, because each template will change your post's setup, okay? So just be sure that you're happy with the the template and layout and everything before you start really getting into posting, okay? And then we're going to click on save every time, make sure. And when you have your list of page elements here, you can grab hold of them by clicking the right mouse and holding it down, and then rearrange the order of your new page elements here. Then make sure you click save at the top, and then it'll save the order of things. Okay? And then, there you go. You're all set up. You can go view your blog. I went ahead and made a post before I showed you the front, just the one. But now you're ready to go post and get crazy with your blog. Do what you want. Make pictures, videos, all that.
Okay. See? It's pretty simple, right? Setting up a blog site is very, very basic. But it's easier when somebody shows you how to do it, yeah? Definitely come look up theloneblog.com. That's my Blogspot blog. It's my favorite one, actually. I have a couple other ones, but you can get to them from my profile page. And definitely leave a comment and leave a little URL for your blog so I can come see it and say hello. It was great meeting you guys, and the next one will be about WordPress. So if you're interested in starting a WordPress blog, stay tuned, right? I'll talk to you soon. Que cua vivi o mande que am te.